Hello students, in the previous class we have discussed the synopsis for chapter haloalkenes, halovarines. So we have discussed monohalides as well as dihalides, and in today's class we will continue from trihalides and we will discuss the haloarenes. Okay, before starting, if you are not subscribed to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel Catalyst Chemistry Classes KP. Students, in the trihalides, first we will go for what is meant by trihalides. So we know that trihalides are the halogen derivative. Like in alkanes, if we replace three hydrogen atoms by three halogens, we'll call it as trihalides. And their general properties are like they will also known as halo forms with CHX3 is its general formula. Okay, first we will consider the general methods of preparation. So consider the general method of preparation, so which consists of many different types of preparation. Like it is going to prepare from methane. So what's the formula for methane? It's CH4. Okay, methane on treating with the three molecules of chlorine in sunlight, which is going to form CHCl3 with the preparation of three molecules of HCl. And here we can observe by halo form reaction. So these trihalides are halo form, are also prepared from halo form reaction, and we can call it as laboratory methods of preparation. And so here the starting material we have to consider is CH3CH2H, that is ethanol, or we can also consider CH3COCH, that is acetone. So these starting materials on treating with the bleaching powder. So student, what is meant by bleaching powder? What its composition is? CaOCl2, calcium hypochloride, and hydrolysis it is going to form CHCl3, which is chloroform with the preparation of HCOO twice Ca or CH3COO twice Ca. So this is the method of preparation of haloform. Then what is the mechanism behind this reaction? We will consider the mechanism. The CaOCl2, which is bleaching powder, treated with water, which is going to liberate chlorine and which is going to form calcium hydroxide. And the starting material CH3CH2OH, that is ethanol, on treating with this chlorine, so which is going to form CH3CHO, that is ethanol, with the liberation of two molecules of HCl. And this reaction is generally known as oxidation. Oxidation takes place. And that ethanol CH3CHO and treating further with the chlorine, sixth component of chlorine, which is going to form CCl3CHO, that is trichloroethanol. 2, 2, 2 trichloroethanol it is, then which is going to liberate three molecules of HCl. And here halogenation takes place, hence this step is generally called as halogenation. And the liberated CCl3CHO on treating with the calcium hydroxide, is going to form chloroform, CHCl3, with the regression of HCOO twice CA. And this reaction is generally known as hydrolysis. So this is the mechanism behind the haloform reaction. And if acetone is used, then CHCl3 is formed into two steps. That is, one is chlorination and the one is hydrolysis. No need to carry out the oxidation reaction. Now we'll go for two types of haloform reaction. One is positive haloform reaction. What is meant by positive haloform reaction? So, which is very simple. If the reaction which gives haloform with alkali and halogen is called as positive haloform reaction. So, what are the groups that gives positive haloform reaction? So, if you consider alcohols, examples, if you consider CH3, CH, so consider this as Z and OH. Like this Z may be CH3 group, then C2H5 group, or any other alkyl group, etc. Then aldehydes also gives positive haloform test. In that, only acetaldehyde gives positive haloform test, like CH3 C double bond OH. And in case of ketone, CH3 C double bond O set may be again CH3 C2H5 R group or aryl group. So these groups generally gives positive haloform test. Then the second type is a negative haloform test or negative haloform reaction. So here, the reaction in which haloforms are not formed with chlorine as well as in general halogens and alkali, which is nothing but if the reaction takes place between alkali and halogen, if the reaction does not give haloform, means which is considered as negative haloform reaction. And most of the compounds like CH3, C double bond O, Cl, acid chloride, and CH3, C double bond O, OH, that is carboxylic acid, and CH3, C double bond O, NH, that is amide group, and like CH3 C double bond O O CH3. So these groups that do not show haloform reaction, hence they are the example for negative haloform reaction, which means which do not give haloform and reaction between alkali as well as halogen. Now, we'll go for preparation of pure chloroform. Preparation of pure chloroform, CHCl3. Okay, let me consider like chloral hydrate. We have to consider chloral hydrate like CCl3CHO dot 2H2O. This is nothing but a chloral hydrate on treating with the NaOH. Is light excess of alkali, which is going to form a pure chloroform, CHCl3, with the liberation of HCOONa, that is sodium formate, then with the liberation of 2 fifths of water. So chloral hydrate and treating with base, which gives a pure form of chloroform. Then this chloral can also be used in the preparation of PDT. So, which is also used in the preparation of DDT. So, CCl3CHO plus 2H is chlorobenzene, which is Cl, and treating with H2SO4, this is in concentrated H2SO4, which is going to form CCl3CH, then benzene ring Cl. Similarly, here we have one more benzene ring with Cl. And this molecule is known as DDT. What is the full form of DDT? It's dichlorodiphenyltrichloroethane. DDT full form is dichlorodiphenyltrichloroethane. And let me go for the industrial method of preparation of chloroform. CH3CH2OH, ethanol or acetone, CH3COCH3. And treating with aqueous sodium chloride in electrolysis process, which is going to form chloroform, CHCl3, with the liberation of HCOONH, that is sodium formate, or CH3COONH, sodium acetate. So these are the methods of preparation of chloroform. Now, if you consider physical properties, chloroform is colorless and sweet smelling liquid, and its boiling point is 61 degrees Celsius, and it is insoluble in water. So these are the some important physical properties of chloroform. And which it have density more than water, and chloroform is used as anesthetic. It is used as anesthetic. Then we will go for chemical properties. So these are the physical properties. Let me go for chemical properties. So chemical properties, that includes the chemical reaction. Like this chloroform undergoes oxidation reaction. So what is meant by oxidation? We are CHCl3 on oxidation, addition of oxygen in presence of air and light, going to form COCl2 with the liberation of HCl. And this COCl2, which is known as phosgene gas. Phosgene gas is also known as carbonyl chloride. Carbonyl chloride. And the preparation of carbonyl chloride or phosgene gas is limited because it is nothing but a poisonous gas. Hence, it is restricted. This chloroform is poured in dark colored bottles which are filled up with the brim to prevent the oxidation of chloroform into COCl2. Hence, it is avoided and it is stored in dark colored bottles. Then, the second chemical property is hydrolysis. Okay, what is meant by hydrolysis? It is nothing but breaking of bond by the addition of water. Okay, here CHCl3 chloroform, and treating with aqueous potassium hydroxide. So all the chlorine atoms are replaced by OH group. So, and this molecule is very unstable. Because of its instability, which loses a molecule of water, and it is going to form HCOOH, that is formic acid. And this formic acid is again treated with the KOH, which is going to form HC double bond O, OK. That is, so potassium salts of carboxylic acid. Then, the next important reaction is carbylamine reaction. Carbylamine reaction, which is more important. And carbylamine reaction is also known as isocyanide test. Isocyanide test. Or which is also known as Hoffman's carbylamine reaction. So carbylamine reaction, isocyanate test, as well as Hofmann's carbylamine reaction, all are same. So here, that primary amines, that is, it may be aliphatic or aromatic, on treating with chloroform, CHCl3, in presence of potassium hydroxide, which is going to form isocyanates. So this is the carbylamine test. And we know that isocyanates are having an unpleasant smell. Unpleasant means which is offensive or a bad smell. What is the mechanism behind this carbylamine reaction? We will write the general reaction like primary amine RMH2 and heating with the chloroform in presence of potassium hydroxide, which is going to form isocyanate with the general formula RMC. Okay, let me explain the mechanism. So, mechanism includes the multiple steps here. If you consider CHCl3 in presence of COOH, it's going to go to reaction to give an electrophile, that is CCl2. Consider this as an electrophile. And now this RNH2 group, that is primary amine group, we know that nitrogen consists of one lone pair electron, and that absorbs this electrophile CCl2, which is also having one lone pair electron, and which is going from RNH2, and due to 4 bonds nitrogen carries positive charge, then CCl carbon, which is having 3 bonds, hence it carries negative charge, and 2 HCl molecule, so HCl present above and below, which eliminated from the reaction condition, and which is going to form RN(NN)3. This is known as isocyanate, that is alkyl isocyanate. If you consider aromatic primary amine, which is going to form aryl isocyanate. And remember one more thing, carbylamine reaction is exhibited by only primary amine, which may be aromatic or aliphatic. Then the next chemical property, that is a Reimer-Tyman reaction. Reimer-Tyman reaction, which is in simply known as the RT reaction. Okay, now we'll write the general reaction for Reimer-Tyman reaction. First, we'll consider phenol and treating with the CHCl3 in presence of COOH. So, chloroform in presence of COOH, which is going to form OH, then CHO. What is the name of this compound? It's salicylaldehyde. Salicylaldehyde. And what is the IUPAC name of this compound? It's R2-hydroxybenzaldehyde. R2-hydroxybenzaldehyde. Then, what is the mechanism behind this Reimer-Tyman reaction? First, we're going to write CHCl3 and treating with COOH. In the previous type reaction, we have observed the formation of electrophile CCl2. Okay, now phenol on treating with OH minus base. So this grabs the hydrogen atom that is present in the phenol, and which is going to liberate water molecule. And now this benzene ring that consists of O that carries negative charge, and this negative charge shifted towards to form a double bond, then this double bond shifted to adjacent carbon atom, then which is going to form negative charge on this carbon, and here oxygen carries double bond, then this CCl2 electrophile, so attacks that negatively charged benzene molecule. And now it is going to form. So here we know that hydrogen is present, and CCl2 group is attached to that carbon that contains negative charge. And here this carbon carries negative charge because we have only 3 bonds here. and this is going to shift to hydrogen, and hydrogen it is to form double bond. Now this is going to form one more intermediate, like oxygen carries negative charge here, because when hydrogen is eliminated as H plus ion, which donates an electron towards benzene ring. So due to the valency, to satisfy the valency of carbon, here double bond is shifted to oxygen again. So which is going to form the intermediate like this. And here an addition of base OH minus, those chlorine groups are replaced by OH group. Here O minus element as it is. Instead of Cl, OH groups are present. Then, which is an acidification, which loses a molecule of water here, and which is going to form a final product, that is the aldehyde. So this is the mechanism behind the Reimer-Tymon reaction. And here, one more thing, students. So in the place of a chloroform like CHCl3, if we use CCl4, then which forms a salicylic acid as a product instead of salicyl aldehyde. So we'll write the note like, instead of chloroform, that is CHCl3, if we use CCl4, carbon tetrachloride, which is going to form salicylic acid as an end product. So this is, which is also known as the Kolbe's reaction. Now, discuss the next chemical property, like reaction with the acetone CH3 CO CH3. So let me consider acetone CH3 CO CH3 on treating with this chloroform CHCH3. So in presence of the base, it is going to form an chloritone, that is CH3 CCH3 OH single bond CCl3. So this is having the name chloritone, and which acts as hypnotic. And the next chemical property is the reaction with HNO3. Okay, if this chloroform CHCl3 on treating with HNO3, like light HNO3 like this, OHNO2. So which is going to liberate water molecule. CCl3 is directly attached to NO2 group now. And this molecule or compound is known as chloropicrine, or which is also known as nitrochloroform, which is commonly known as tear gas, which produces tears or ice. The next chemical property is reaction with CH3 CH double bond CH2, alkene. Now this compound CH3 CH double bond CH2, propene, on treating with CHCl3 chloroform in presence of peroxide group. So which is, okay, here we have carbon, that CHCl3 on treating with peroxide gives CCl3, which is having free radical. Now this free radical attacks with carbon, then this is going to form CH3 CH hydrogen, so this is a free radical addition, because here we got a free radical that attacks the carbon. chemical property is a reaction with CHCl3 on treating with the metal silver, which is going to form alkyne. CH triple bond CH, that is ethane. Then the last chemical property is a reaction with FCR. Okay, now this 3PHH on treating with CHCl3 in presence of ELC, the chlorinating agent, is going to form PH3CH. The name of this compound is a triphenyl methane. Triphenyl methane. So this is about the methods of preparation, physical properties as well as chemical properties of chloroform. Now, in the chloroform, we have to know some properties about freon. So first, you should know what is meant by freon. These are the chloro-fluoro derivatives. Chloro-fluoro derivatives of methane and ethane. So chloro-fluoro derivatives of methane and ethane are generally known as freons. So write some example like CF2Cl2, which is difluoromethane. Similarly, you can write C2F2Cl4, which is the tetrachlorodifluoroethane. And most useful freon is CF2Cl2, which is commercially known as freon 12. So these are some of the examples of freon. Then we'll go for the next important compound like Grignard reagent. Grignard reagent. Okay, what is meant by Grignard reagent? And what's the formula to represent Grignard reagent? It is represented by formula RMGX. Alkyl magnesium halide. How we can prepare Grignard reagent? So methods of preparation is very simple. So here Grignard reagent are prepared in the laboratory by the action of alkyl halide or alkyl halide on magnesium metal in presence of dry ether. So which is going to form the compound Grignard reagent, that is RMGX, which is also known as alkyl magnesium halide. And the easy of formation of Grignard reagent is in the order like Ri is greater than RBr greater than RCl. And here we are used the dry ether, which is used to dissolve the Grignard reagent by coordination. And what are the different chemical reactions of Grignard reagent? So we can discuss a chemical reaction by using flowchart like RMGX Grignard reagent. So we'll discuss some important chemical reaction, which is on treating with the oxygen followed by H, that is acidification, acid hydrolysis, which is going to form primary alcohol ROH. Similarly, if this RMGX on treating with RCHO, that is aldehyde followed by acid hydrolysis, which is going to form R2CHOH, that is secondary alcohol. And the same RMGX on treating with COR dash like ketone followed by hydrolysis, which is going to form R3COH, which is nothing but tertiary alcohol. And If this Grignard reagent on treating with RCOOAT followed by hydrolysis, that is taken in 2:1 ratio, which is going to form R3OH. R3COH, like tertiary alcohol only. Now, this Grignard reagent on treating with again RCOOAT in 1:1 ratio, like Grignard reagent and RCOOAT in 1:1 ratio, which is going to form RCHO, that is aldehyde. And this Grignard reagent, if it is treated with RCN, which is cyanide, followed by hydrolysis, which is going to form RCOR, that is ketone. Similarly, if this Grignard reagent on treating with the carbon dioxide followed by hydrolysis, which is going to form RCOOH, that is acid. Then, if this RMGX on treating with RX, like alkyl halide, which is going to form RR, that is higher alkane. And if this Grignard reagent on treating with ClNH2, which is going to form RNH2, that is nothing but primary amine. And this RMGX on treating with ClCN, chlorocyanide, which is going to form RCN, that is cyanide. If it is treated with ClCOOAT, which is going to form RCOOAT, that is ester. So still, so many chemical properties of Grignard reagent is there, because it is a very good, you are very useful reagent that is going to form n number of organic compounds. Now, let me discuss haloarenes. What is meant by haloarenes? Which is nothing but the halogen derivatives of aromatic hydrocarbons. If halogen atom is directly attached to the pentene ring, then the compound is known as haloarene. The examples are chlorobenzene, then 2-chlorotoluene, 2-gamma-4-dichlorotoluene, etc. Let me discuss the methods of preparation of haloarenes. So general methods of preparation that includes halogenation of benzene. Let me consider chlorination of benzene in presence of a ClCl3, which is going to form chlorobenzene with the liberation of a molecule of HCl. If we take phenol, CH5OH, and treating with PCl5, phosphorus pentachloride, and heating, which is going to form chlorobenzene with the liberation of POCl3 as well as a molecule of HCl. Then, if you consider one more phosphorus halide, like 3 molecules of phenol, C6H5OH, and treating with POCl3, what is the product of end in the previous reaction? So, which is going to form C6H5 thrice PO4 with the liberation of 3 molecules of HCl. So, these are some methods of preparation of haloarene. Now we'll discuss chemical properties. Chemical properties of haloarenes. So what are the important chemical properties of haloarenes? Let me discuss the first one, that is chlorine on treating with chlorobenzene on treating with the sodium hydroxide. Chlorobenzene on treating with sodium hydroxide. So we have to maintain the condition like 623 Kelvin temperature and 300 atmospheric pressure, followed by acidification. It's going to form phenol, C6H5OH, with the liberation of NaCl. Here, the presence of electron withdrawing group on ring makes the nucleophilic substitution easier. So we can discuss the nucleophilic substitution reaction also. And the reactivity order for nucleophilic substitution reaction is like this. So trinitrochlorobenzene, which is more stable or more reactive than nitrochlorobenzene. This is the reactivity order for nucleophilic substitution reaction. And the second chemical property is the Wittig's reaction. What is meant by Wittig reaction? So here we know that two aryl halides on treating with two atoms of sodium metal, so which is in presence of dry ether, which is must ensure condition for Wood-Wittig reaction as well as Wittig reaction, which is going to form 5-phenyl. Like that, we have diphenyl or biphenyl with the liberation of 2-NaCl. So this is about Wood-Wittig reaction. Then next chemical property is Wood-Wittig reaction. Wood-Wittig reaction. So it is very simple to remember, easy to remember. Like if you consider Wood's reaction, we have to consider two alkyl halide, and Wood-Wittig reaction, one alkyl and one aryl halide. And in Wittig's reaction, we are going to take two molecules of aryl halides only. So Wood-Wittig reaction. Mixture of alkyl and aryl halides and treating with sodium metal. Take Cl, it is C3H7Cl. C3H7Cl. So, which is going to liberate two molecules of NaCl. Which is going to form C3H7 with the liberation of two molecules of NaCl. So this is Wood-Wittig reaction. Now we'll go for electrophilic substitution reaction, which is the most important chemical property, like electrophilic substitution reaction. So in that electrophilic substitution reaction, we'll consider chlorination of chlorobenzene, like in general halogenation in presence of anhydrous FeCl2, which is going to form ortho mixture of ortho para dichlorobenzene. Because we know that chlorine is ortho para directing group, hence which is going to form two mixture of product like ortho dichlorobenzene para dichlorobenzene. And in electrophilic substitution reaction only, we can also discuss the nitration of chlorobenzene. So for nitration, chlorobenzene on treating with the nitrating mixture, which is nothing but a mixture of concentrated H2SO4 and concentrated HNO3. So, which is also going to form mixture of ortho and para substituted product like this. So, ortho nitro chlorobenzene, para nitro chlorobenzene. Exactly. The third electrophilic substitution reaction is the sulfonation of chlorobenzene. For sulfonation of chlorobenzene, chlorobenzene on treating with the concentrated H2SO4, which is also going to form two mixture like ortho as well as para substituted chlorovinyl. That is two mixture of ortho as well as para substituted product. Then this chlorobenzene on treating with the CH3Cl in presence of anhydrous aluminium chloride. So what's the name of the reaction? It's Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So which is also going to form mixture of ortho as well as para substituted product. So it is 2-chloro-toluene as well as 4-chloro-toluene. We can also write it as the names like ortho-chloro-toluene, para-chloro-toluene. Or in common naming system, we can call it as ortho-methyl-chlorobenzene, para-methyl-chlorobenzene, etc. So this is about synopsis for the chapter haloalkanes as well as haloarenes. So students, if this is helpful, so please like and share with your contacts. And if you do not subscribe to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.